A theme is one direction to which you can develop a story. So you are trying, this is again an example that I am citing here, is whenever intrinsically or without knowing the nuances of a process, you try to first define what you are trying to communicate through this movie. That exactly is what you call by the message. So before you have a story, the message actually doesn't exist. You call it the theme. This is to be married, this is to be mixed with the intrinsic, or rather the predominant emotion in your story. If you're trying to make a sad story or sorrowful story, if you're trying to make a thriller with a lot of surprises, these are all your predominant emotions mixed with a theme. This is where you all start with the story. Then you write from the heart, and then your subconscious will help you. This is actually the process. It definitely will work. I came up with long back, a girl came to me and said, I want to write a story. She doesn't know what to write, but she said, I want to write a story. It's about a girl. She wants to write a story about a girl. So then she said, well, the story is about when the girl starts from her house to a bus stop is where the story happens. We started thinking that how can a story happen when she travels from her home or walks from her home to a bus stop, which is very nearby? And what could be her goal? So we thought it could be she wanted to attend a marriage, and she wanted to wear all those silk saris and ornaments and kind of stuff. And so then you say, how can you make that story grow? Then someone was saying that there could be a guy who irons clothes, who is stationed there. There could be a set of boys who do street cricket there. So these are characters on her way to that bus stop. So the story is actually growing because we are getting characters. And she had given her sari to be ironed, and the man couldn't give that on time. So these are all conflicts. These are all obstructions to achieve her goal, and the story grows like that. So it's a very, very clinical kind of a process which definitely will help you as a principal, definitely. So basically, when it comes to certain stories or screenplays, what engages you is not just the action of the character, but the dramatic action of the character. That actually gives you the intensity of engagement. I think the complexity or intensity is lesser in some stories. Why? Because the drama is lesser. The stakes of the character is lesser. There are so many things that we have to learn. So the basic thing is, the more the drama is there in a story, the more engagement there is in a story. That doesn't mean that there cannot be stories with lesser drama. The only difference is, see, if this is the kind of graph that you have, this is the growth of story. There can also be a growth like this. The element of dramaturgy is lesser. That doesn't mean that the story cannot exist. The story can exist with a lesser drama. That's why there are different types of stories. But the more engagement value happens when the conflicts grow to the maximum. Or even in television, when you work, even the news nowadays is sensitivized. They are bringing in drama into it. So when there is more drama, people want to watch it, which is there in every human psyche. That is embedded. That's what I say, there is a dramatic code inside us which actually provokes you to get the value of this drama.
How do you write a screenplay for that?
The decision of making a structure is to arrive at the best possible engagement value for that story. If you have a story, you have to tell that well. Even if the story is great, if you don't tell it well, it won't get into the audiences. So whatever stories that you remember so far is all told very well, even if the story is very, very simple. It's told well. So telling well is all that matters, even if you have a very simple, straight story. And telling well has a lot of nuances you can learn, is what I'm trying to say.